The following portion of Daytime Blue Ridge is sponsored by...
When it comes to buying a home, it's important to know what to expect. Ryan Stenger from Freedom First is here today to answer some of our mortgage questions and update us all on some changes headed our way. Thank you so much for coming in. So we know that mortgages have, you know, different rates, different numbers involved, but you're going to explain prime rates.
Yeah. So prime rates are the interest rates that are impacted by our short-term loans. So this is not mortgage loans. These are your automobile loans, your home equity lines of credit, even your credit cards. And when we hear the prime rate is continuing to rise, and it is, we've seen two rate increases this year.
Okay.
And so, you know, if you're in a home equity line, for example, it might be a good idea to talk to your local credit union or bank about refinancing that into a fixed interest rate before those continue to creep up.
Okay, so yeah, how is that affecting mortgage shoppers?
Yeah, no, so it's affecting them a lot. I mean, they're going in and looking to make sure they're paying attention to their home equity lines, and they're seeing the interest rates on those go up and are starting to look for a low fixed rate. And if you have a home equity line of credit right now, it would be a good idea to start looking at maybe converting that into a fixed rate loan.
Okay, so it is increasing, right?
Yeah, it has been increasing.
Why does that happen?
Yeah, no, that's a great question. So the prime rate, again, is the rate that all lenders use to create short-term rates, place pricing on short-term rates.
Okay.
The Fed is raising interest rates, and the prime rate is closely linked to what the Fed does.
Okay.
So every time you hear on the news that the Fed is raising rates, you're like, okay, what does that mean for me?
That means
your short-term loans, those interest rates are increasing.
Okay, so if we already have a mortgage, is this going to
affect us? Okay. No, it shouldn't. It should not at all.
Okay.
You know, unless your interest rate is variable and tied to that prime rate. If you've got a fixed interest rate, you should be fine. If you've got a second mortgage that is a home equity loan or home equity line of credit, you might want to talk to your local bank or credit union about making sure that you're okay and protected there from rate increases that we're anticipating are going to come.
Okay, so maybe some conversations need to be happening. So when should somebody consider refinancing their home equity line?
Well, I think any time that somebody doesn't have a plan for paying that off in the near future, you know, it depends on what your plan is for paying that off. I think that it would be a good time to have a discussion with somebody. And then, you know, if you can't, you know, if you're scared about not being able to handle those payments, definitely get in and talk to your local credit union about what they can do to help.
And people can come talk to Freedom First about all of this. Have you all kind of explain it?
Absolutely. Okay. And everything's on a case by case as of what makes sense for one person might not make sense for another.
Yeah.
So it's sitting down and just having a consultation with somebody who knows what they're talking about with the finance stuff is a great idea.
So you can absolutely get in touch with Freedom First. They have a ton of branches to serve all of your needs. You can give them a call, 1-866-389-0244. Ryan, thank you so much for coming in.
You're welcome.